Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. Today's session we are going to discuss about 8085 microprocessor division program. In this division program, we take it as a two value. The first value is a numerator value, it's a 16 bit value. Denominator value is 8 bit value. Before writing the program, first you are declaring the values. Here I am taking two values. The numerator is 380, denominator 90. This value is a decimal value. You just divide this content. Quotient is 4. Remainder is 20. First you convert this decimal value into hexadecimal value. The equivalent hexadecimal value is 0173. It's a 16 bit content. Equivalent hexadecimal value for 90 is 5A. Just dividing 0173 divided by 5A. You can get the result. Quotient is 4, remainder is 20. This 20 equivalent hexadecimal value is 14. It's a response of this program. It's a simple program. The beginning instruction LXIH800H. This 16 bit content considered as a immediate value because here I represent for this content is an immediate data. This data is transferred to HL pair register. After execution of this instruction, HL pair value 8000H. This content is transferred to HL pair. The next instruction move A comma M. Whatever value present in this memory location, the content is transferred to accumulator register. Now the memory location is 8000H. Here the 8 bit value is 7C. After execution of this instruction, accumulator value 7C. The third instruction increment H. Now you get a higher 8 bit value. First you increment the HL pair content. Before execution, the HL pair value is 8000H. After increment, HL pair content 8001H. The next instruction move B, M. Whatever value present in 8001H, that content is transferred to B register. It's a higher order 8 bit value. This content is transferred to B register. After execution of this instruction, B value is 01H. So far, you get the lower 8 bit value and higher 8 bit value. Then the next instruction, you can get the denominator value. Now, you increment the HL pair content. After incrementing the HL pair, 8002H. Next one, move C comma M. Whatever value present in the memory location, this content is transferred to C register. Now you get a denominator value. So denominator value is 5A. This 5A is transferred to C register. Next one, increment B. Before execution of this instruction, B value is 01. After execution of this instruction, B value 02H. LXIH 0000H. Now you clear in the HL pair value because you store the result in HL pair register. After execution of this instruction, HL value you clear 20000. Next instruction, subtract C. You just subtracting the accumulator content with C register content because in 8085 microprocessor there is no direct instruction to performing the division function. So you apply the repeated subtraction. Subtraction C. This instruction says A minus C. Just subtracting A value minus C value, the result is stored in an accumulator register. The accumulator content is 7C. First you write the binary number of 7C. It's a binary number of 7C. Then you take this as the 5A equivalent binary number is 0101010. Just subtracting this A value and C value, 0 minus 0, 0. You can take a borrow from nearest bit 10. 10 minus 1, 1. This value is 0, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. 0, 1, 0, 0. After subtraction of A and C, you can get the result 2, 2. It's a first iteration. Then next instruction JC skip. This subtraction, it produces the carry or no carry. here it not producing the any carry. This instruction is false. It execute the next instruction, increment H. Now the HL pair value you increment. After incrementing, you can get the result is 0001. Before execution of this instruction, HL pair value, all the values are 0. After incrementing, you can get the result 0001. The next instruction jump to, without checking any condition, the program counter it move to the loop label. Now the program counter point loop instruction. This instruction says subtract C. Once again, you subtract whatever value present in accumulator, that content subtract with C register, C content. You write the C value 5A, subtracting this value 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 0. You can take the borrow, this content 10, 10 minus 1, 1, this value 1, 1 minus 1, 0, 0. You can take the borrow from outside. This content post here, this value 10, 10 minus 1, 1, 1. After subtraction, the second iteration, you can get the result C, 8. Now you check the condition, JC skip. In this subtraction, it produces a carry. The condition is true. Once the condition is true, it go to the loop skip. The program counter point the skip memory location. Here the instruction is decrement B. After decrement the B register content, now B value is 01. Before execution, B value is 02. After decrementing, B value is 01. Then it executes the next instruction, J is a store. This instruction says the B register content is 0 value or non-zero value. Here the B register content is non-zero. So non-zero means it's a, this instruction is false. So it's false. It executes the next instruction, jump INCR. So INCR is a one loop. After execution of this instruction, the program counter point this memory location, INCR. So in this place, here instruction is increment H. After the second subtraction, you incrementing the HL pair value. After incrementing, the result is 0002. Now jump loop, it go to here. Here the instruction is subtract C. Once again, you subtract the C value with A value. Now A value is C8. Write the C content 5A. Subtracting this value 0, 0 minus 1, there is no possibility. You can take the borrow from nearest bit, 1 minus 1, 10 minus 1, 1, 1. So here also 0, 0 minus 1, there is no possibility. You can take the borrow from nearest bit, 1, 1, 10, 10 minus 1, 1, 1 minus 1, 0, 1. So 10 minus 1, 1, 0. It's a third iteration. So after the third subtraction, you can get the result 6E. Now you check the condition, JC skip. Here the carry value is 0. The condition is false. It execute the next instruction. Now HL pair value increment by 1. You can get the result 0003. Then jump loop. Again the program counter point the loop instruction. Subtract C. The accumulator content subtract with C register. The C register content is 5A. Once again you subtract 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 0, 1, 0, 0 minus 1, there is no possibility. You can take the borrow from nearest bit, 10 minus 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. So after the fourth subtraction, you can get the result 1, 4. Now you check the condition, JC skip, there is no carry. So it execute the next instruction, increment H. Now the HL pair value is 0004. Then jump loop, without any checking any condition, it go to the loop label, subtract A minus C. You're subtracting the A value and C value. Now 0, 0 minus 1, there is no possibility. You can take the borrow from nearest to bit, 10 minus 1, 1, this value is 0, 0, can take the borrow 10 minus 1, 1. So here 0. You can take the borrow from outside 1, 1, 1, 10. 10 minus 1, 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 0, 1. After subtraction, you can get the result. This is the result. Now we check the condition JC, skip. Now carry value is 1. This condition is true. Once the condition is true, it go to the loop, skip. The instruction is decrement B. After decrementing this instruction, now B value is 00. Before execution, B value is 01. After decrement, B content is 00. The next instruction, J is a store. Now you check whether the B value is 0 value or non-zero value. Here, the B value is 0 value. Once B value is 0, this condition is true. It go to the loop store. Now the program counter point, the memory location store. Here the instruction is add C. Whatever value present in accumulator, that content add with C register. The accumulator content is 1011 1010. Now you add the accumulator content with C register content. The C register value is 5A. Just add in the content 0 plus 0 0, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, 1, 1 plus 1 sum 0 carry 1, triple 1 sum 1 carry 1, 0 carry 1, 0 carry 1, 0. The carry bit is 1. After addition, you can get the result. The result is 14. After addition of the accumulator content and C register content, you can get the result is 14. The equivalent decimal number is 20. It's a remainder value. The next instruction, exchange. Whatever content present in HL pair, that content is transferred to DE pair. So finally, the HL pair content is 0004. This value is transferred to DE pair. Now, DE pair content is 0004. The next instruction, LXIH 8050. This 8050 is the output memory location. This immediate data is transferred to HL pair. After execution of this instruction, the HL pair value is 8050. The next instruction, move M, E. So E is a lower 8 bit value. E content is 04. After execution of this instruction, the E content is transferred to the memory location 8050. After execution, the result 04 is stored in a memory location 8050. The next instruction, increment H. Now the HL pair value is 8051 H. 8051 H. After increment, the next instruction, move M, D. Whatever value present in D register, that content is transferred to the memory location 8051. Now the D value is 00. This content is transferred to the memory location 8051. So for you transferring the quotient value 0004. The next one, increment H. Now increment the HL pair content 8052. Move M, A. Whatever value present in A register, that content is moved to M. The A register content is 14. This content is transferred to the memory location 8052. 14, it's a remainder value. The end of the instruction is halt. The halt declared in the closing the program. There is no instruction to execute the program. Before writing the program, first you decide the denominator value and numerator value. The 16 bit numerator value divided by 8 bit denominator value. You can apply in the repeated subtraction process. Finally, you obtain the result. Thanks for watching my channel.